All right, so you guys know what today is.
Sorry I'm late.
Jordan again.
What's up, man?
It's freezing outside.
It feels like this winter's never gonna end.
Yeah, man, do you think we're gonna have six more weeks of winter or an early spring?
What?
All right, so you guys know what today is.
Sorry I'm late.
Jordan again.
All right, well, we're gonna work on new things today.
It's freezing outside.
Yeah.
Do you think we're gonna have six more weeks of winter or an early spring?
What?
All right, so you guys know what today is.
Sorry, I'm late.
Jordan again.
All right, well, we're gonna work on some new thing today. And
it's freezing outside.
Dude, what is? We just had this conversation twice.
Do you think we're gonna have six more weeks of winter or an early spring?
I'm not crazy, man. What is going on?
It's coming out good.
Hey Centennial, it's your favorite host Jaden Zayas, and we're back with another great episode. I hope you guys enjoy. Remember, help is always available. The Crisis Text Line and Suicide Prevention Lifeline are listed below.
Hey Kate, we're about to go to lunch. You wanna come?
Yeah, I can use a break.
My name is Chef Mooney, and my class is AP Brunch.
Hi, my name is Estella Brown, and I'm in AP Brunch.
Hi, my name is John Bustery, and I've taken this class last year, but I've transferred to Centennial this year for a new look at the culinary movement here.
It is in between lunch, breakfast and lunch, AP Brunch.
So whereas last year was a lot of like fundamentals with chopping, cutting, we're really getting into the more advanced techniques this year about, you know, making some intense stuff in the kitchen, you know, right now.
Stop, I'm so sick and tired of you, stop that.
Yes, chef.
Well, recently we just made some really nice avocado toast. I'm not a big fan of avocado toast, so. But don't tell chef that, he'll get a little mad.
What are you not a fan of?
Nothing, chef. We also have been making these really nice omelets too, with the eggs that we've been, you know, making.
We've got some local pastures outside, so those organic chickens have just been doing a lot for the program here. But we've named a few, but I mean, the longer we stay here, the more we're gonna have, so it's only growth for the program right now.
I don't know if I'm allowed to say if the oranges are back there or not. I don't want to get like kicked out or anything. So.
The orange juice is made from our secret grove behind the practice field, behind the chicken coops, both of which were heavily damaged when Kirby Smart landed his helicopter on the practice field last week.
AP Brunch highlight. I mean, as far as I can say, I wasn't here for it this year, but back at Bishop Sycamore, I remember we got word that at Centennial, Chef Mooney was doing a lot of crazy stuff with the kids. I don't say too much, but I would stay away.
My favorite thing about teaching this class is the joy that I get when children fail. When making... cut the camera. First off, don't look me in the eyes.
My advice to anyone to take this class is to be really nice to Chef. He can be a little scary sometimes, but overall it's a great class. Just, you know, make sure that your manners are up to par.
Where all your dreams come true, where you're not full and you're not excited and you spend too much money. AP Brunch.
This week we have varsity soccer player Hannah Sherman as our student talent. Let's check it out.
My name is Hannah Sherman and my talent is soccer. I've been playing soccer for as long as I can remember. One of my dreams is to play varsity soccer at Centennial and then further my playing career in college at a D1 school. I haven't committed anywhere because I'm still keeping my options open. My relationship with the girls on the team is just beyond comparing because we just love each other so much. It's not even a community, it's a family, and I just can't imagine playing without them.
Wait, Hannah's the student talent? Who?
Yeah.
Did she even make the team?
I practiced 25-8, 366. It's nonstop, non-go, like full commitment on my part. I always manage to find a way to do my drills, even when I don't really want to do it. I have to do this. It's like a part of me. Soccer is me. Personally, I don't believe there's off days in soccer, for me at least. Like others, yeah, sure, but none of them are committed like me. I am different. My family is super supportive in me. They're just as committed as I am. Like my mom puts a 5-minute time limit on my phone, and most people see that as a downfall, but honestly, it only makes me better. And that way I can just focus on my workouts, focus on getting better, and just being the best I am.
I'm Hannah Sherman, and you're watching The Loft.
Hello, Centennial. Welcome to Spicy Ones. I'm your host, Zach Faulkner. Today, we're here with Mansur Williamson and Brian Baylor, two of our star players here at Centennial Basketball. And today, we're going to be answering some hot questions with some hot wings. So you guys stay tuned. All right, so we have some hot wings here in front of us. You guys grab a wing, and we'll get into it. So, first question on the table, how's it been the last 3 years with Coach Barksdale?
Yeah. So, I say my 3-year experience with Barksdale has been good just because he's a good coach, you know. I mean, he does a lot for the players that doesn't show up. Like, he does a lot in the backgrounds, behind the scenes, and that's really it. What you got to say?
For me, Barksdale has been really just working on me, my composure, not flipping out all the time. Yeah, and just being maintained on the court, on and off, being in school, working on my work, and just keeping me on the right path.
So now we got the slow burn sauce. This is the hottest sauce from Taco Mac. Yes, sir. Let's see what it's talking about.
Nice smell, man.
Ooh, damn.
Look at that.
Alrighty.
Oh, shit.
Gentlemen, grab a wing. Let's see. Alrighty. Are we going sauce? Are we going sauce and then more sauce to cancel
it out?
Ranch, yeah.
Alright.
I'm gonna have to go with the blue cheese to get right out of the ranch. Alright, y'all ready?
Yeah.
Let's do it. I'm not gonna lie, I think the blue cheese canceled it out.
Yeah, sure.
So thank you guys. Centennial, it's been a great one. Spicy Ones, back at it. Thank you, Mansur and Brian.
Yes, sir.
We really appreciate you guys, and we're going to be doing this a lot more often, so you guys stay tuned. Spicy Ones, signing out. Peace.
Go. I ain't never ran from a... No, I ain't never. If I did, cut my legs out right now. I ain't never been with the... Talk snitch talk, always talking about his fault. Oh. Yeah, I'ma stand up, got my bands up. You don't wanna see me pissed off. Real talk, never tell a lie to dog. When it come to them, you gotta play it raw. And I never ever let get to me.
Why not?
Ain't worth my energy.
What you had to do?
Cut them off, make them feel it. I ain't dealing with nothing if it don't make sense to me.
Never ever ever.
I never ever ever go against my camp for some on the other side.
Never ever ever.
I never ever ever put a for the money. Gotta get it when it come to mind. Lately I feel like it's me versus me. Don't see competition, why would you compete?
Huh?
Don't even gotta be woke. Still gonna be up. How? I make a bag in my sleep.
You want me to sit right here?
Alright. Hello, Mr. Vasion. I'm glad you could join us.
Well, hello. I'm glad to be here.
So, Mr. Vasion, what subject do you teach?
Well, I teach an introduction to business class, but I also like to spend some of my free time in the cafeteria.
So, Mr. Vasion, tell us about your personal life.
Well, I live in a wonderful home with my wife and two daughters. Both of them are still alive.
So, Mr. Vasion, what college did you go to?
I went to Oxley University.
Don't you mean Oxford?
No.
Okay, next question.
What's your legal full name?
Excuse me?
Did you not hear the question?
No. Well, I heard the question. I just can't quite figure out why you want to know.
Answer the question.
Well, my first name is Michael.
No, it's not.
What'd you say?
Where'd your accent go? I thought you were from Forkland, Alabama.
Well, yes, sir, I am. I am Forkland, Alabama, born and raised.
No, you're not. You're from Toronto, Canada.
Hey, come back.
Hi, my name is Miss Ferguson, and I teach lit. It's lit. I have been teaching for 4 years, and I've also been at Centennial for 4 years. I teach ninth grade lit, honors, and on level as well. My favorite thing about teaching is telling people to get off their cell phones. My favorite type of music is anything that's really easy to listen to, like acoustic or lo-fi mixes. My favorite TV show right now is probably The Tudors. I really like that one. It's a historical drama about the lives and wives of King Henry VIII, so that one is a really good one. My favorite movie is probably Christmas Vacation. I'll go with that one. I love Christmas Vacation.
My name is Macklin Hennessy.
My name is Addison Gaddy.
Hi, my name is Ramin Salman.
Hi, my name is Ariana Neal.
This last conference, the country that I had was Peru.
I represented the country Guinea.
And my country was Austria.
What role do I have in Model UN? My role as sponsor is mostly a facilitator.
I was one of the delegates.
And I'm the director of mentorship.
So Model UN is a club that represents the UN where students just get assigned a country and then debate issues going around in the world.
So a lot happened. It was a 3-day conference and basically we sat in this committee room, which is with other countries from other schools, for about 6 hours.
So for me, I was Peru, and I was in the committee IAEA, which is the International Atomic Energy Agency. So I basically just talked about like usage of atomic energy in the world to like combat climate change and urbanization and like all these other types of things. And then I just talked about it with other people who like represented different countries.
In my committee, which is UNHCR, we kind of discussed the impact of COVID-19 on refugees, which is a very important and prevalent topic in our world today.
So did any of us receive special awards? Actually, a lot of people did. Like Centennial as a whole won a large delegation for the country of Guinea. And then for me, I won an award for like a verbal award for best speech for the country of Peru.
I am Mr. Hennessy.
My name's Addison Gaddy.
I am Ramin Salman.
I'm Ariana Neal.
And you are watching.
And you're watching.
And you're watching.
And you're watching The Law.
John Coltrane was born on September 23, 1926, in Hamlet, North Carolina. He was an American jazz saxophonist and composer. He led at least 50 recording sessions and appeared on many albums by other musicians. Over the course of his career, Coltrane's music took on an increasingly spiritual dimension. He died at the age 40, July 17, 1967. He remains one of the most influential saxophonists in music history.
This Wednesday was signing day. Congrats to all the athletes who committed.
Last Friday, Centennial beat Johns Creek at home. Wade Cowell leading the team with 17 points, 12 rebounds, and 3 blocks.
Shout out to all of our wrestlers who are heading down to Brunswick this morning to move on to sectionals. St. Andrew, America, Trey Sheffield, Adam Carroll, and Daniel Max. Good luck, guys.
The following Tuesday, Centennial went on the road to defeat Creekview, a score of 61-41. Come out tonight and watch Centennial face Chattahoochee. It'll be at 7:30 at the Round Table. Go Knights!
The undefeated Centennial boys soccer team won their third game against Duluth this week. Also, the girls soccer team won their game against Duluth as well. Now let's go see what soccer's doing.
My name is Mark Bolsky. I teach biology here at Centennial High School, and I'm the head boys varsity soccer coach. So how did I get into soccer? Coaching soccer, my high school soccer coach, when I graduated, I went to a local college and he asked me to be assistant coach. So I've been coaching high school soccer probably since the age of 19, 20. The season so far, we've had two games, we've had one scrimmage, and we've won them all. What I'm most excited about is we have 9 goals for us and 1 against us. So far the season is going really well. The players are responding well in practice, which is awesome. We got a good group of kids. We got 16 underclassmen. We got 5 seniors. So we got a good mixture of talent. Yeah, so we had a game on Tuesday night against Duluth. We won 4-0. The game was very physical, came out with a lot of injuries. However, the players made great adjustments at halftime. And I think what we were most impressed with was our players were able to keep their composure. And what I mean by that, you know, not get physical, not get nasty, where the other team was a little bit. So that's what I'm most proud of those players last night. So, you know, every game we have objectives, 3 to 4 objectives a game. And last night, our 4 objectives were to control the game, control the pace of the game, have nobody score on us, have at least 14 shots on goal, and score on a free kick. And we did all of those. I mean, it's pretty hard to do, you know, most of those objectives, and we were able to accomplish them in one game, and I was so proud of the players at the end of that game. Yeah, so our next home game is next Tuesday at 8 o'clock. And, you know, come out and support the girls at 6 and come out and support the boys at 8. We'd love to see you there. It's a fun team to watch. Go Knights.
My name is Ms. Ferguson. I teach 9th grade lit, and your word of the week is loquacious. Loquacious is an adjective that means excessively talkative. Loquacious.
3 in a row.
No,
but he cleared the entire board.
Can you just be quiet?
I'm not
going to
lie.
The amount of satisfaction from clearing the entire board is so good.
Perfect.
Hey, Centennial. I'm Jackson McCarowitz.
And I'm Aiden Owens.
And I just escaped. Anyways, this is your weekly update. Let's get this started.
A North Carolina man returned a library book to his high school after 43 years. After returning the book, he gave him a heartfelt apology. And in return, they gave him a $10,000 late fee.
In other news, I, myself, Jackson McCarowitz, have been listening to Pink Floyd recently, and I found an astonishing discovery. Their song, Breathe, sounds like SpongeBob screaming. Should we listen to it, guys?
I'd love to.
Absolutely.
All right, let's play it. That's probably about enough.
All I can say is, I was not ready, kids. 18 minutes and 18 seconds. What does that number mean to you? Well, for many, it means alien life. This is because every 18 minutes and 18 seconds, we're getting a radio signal from deep space. People are jumping to conclusions, deciding that this is other life forms, which could mean a lot for the, you know, world of space. But in reality, it's just Elon Musk and his $10 million Malibu mansion messing with NASA.
In other Elon Musk-related news, he said the biggest threat to humanity was we're not having enough kids. He's just mad there's not enough redheaded stepchildren like him. This has been your weekly update. I'm Jackson McCarowitz.
I'm Cody Gage Cole.
And I'm Aiden Owens.
Have a good day, Centennial.
The crew back together again. I sure do love you guys.
Love you too.
We love you too.
Can I go? Can we?
Good afternoon, all. My name is Mac Hennessy. I am one of our social studies teachers here at Centennial, and I also have the pleasure to lead a summer trip every year over to Europe. What were the other questions? We've been doing these trips for the past probably about 10 years at Centennial with a little COVID break in the middle. And I'm very excited that next summer, 2023, we will be traveling to Portugal and Spain. These are locations that are very near and dear to my heart, as I actually studied abroad in Spain when I was in college and lived in the south of Spain for a couple of months. These tours are done through EF Tours, which is a third-party company. They are not organized by Fulton Schools. And the reason I like to use EF is because they provide a lot of ease of travel. They are very responsible when it comes to looking after us, and they're always kind of ahead on what's going on in the places we go. And they make sure that we have the best possible trip. So I love doing these trips because I love to travel. I think it is the best possible experience that all people should take advantage of. And the reason for that is because too often we kind of get caught in our own little bubble of where we live, what's going on in our lives. And we don't realize that out there, there's a whole nother group of people who, while it may seem very different than us in what their actions are or the way they speak, a lot of what makes us human is very much the same. And so getting to travel, you start to realize that there are very few differences. You're still able to communicate, you know, regardless of culture, regardless of language, regardless of country. So I love for students to be able to experience that. I love for them to be able to connect what they've learned in class to what they see out in the real world. And I hope that you guys will be able to join us in summer 2023.
The Centennial Tennis Team is selling spirit wear to raise money for the new season. Please take a moment to check out the link below.
Breaking news. President Lincoln has been assassinated. By who, you may ask? Well, these reports say it's, whole milk? Okay, who wrote this? Did somebody just accidentally write it instead of putting it on their shopping list? Was it like 2% chocolate, almond? Screw it, it was a cow. Why do they have to be such idiots? Anyway, here's an artist's interpretation. In other news, the Winter Olympics are coming up. The first time ever. This will be held at Chamonix, France. I wish everyone the best of luck on the 1924 Olympics. Well, guess we're out of time. Stay classy, Centennial.
Kronos Industries, Time Rift Travel Test 57. Send in the subject.
Wow, that was a great episode, and I hope you guys have an amazing weekend. You're watching The Loft.